coming to the part of hair and skin in the shower, once you're done swimming, so invest in good shampoo and soap. It depends on your body type, basically. I'm not a doctor, so whatever I recommend here is not like scientific or anything. It's just what worked for my body after a lot of research and trial and error of products. I know a lot of you guys out there are trending towards, you know, natural products and things that don't have parabens, don't have chemicals, are all made of natural elements and components. But to be very honest, I have tried those. And I do have one of those as a suggestion, but if you really want to clean your hair, you will have to need some kind of chemical, because chlorine is stuck to your hair, guys, and natural elements, natural ingredients may not do such a good job with it. The first wash is using Revlon Flex. Basically, this is the bodybuilding and protein shampoo for dry and damaged hair. This does a really nice job of cleaning the hair. It's a very good clarifying shampoo. So all the chlorine that's built up on your skin, it will really clean that out. And this is really good value for money. It's 250 bucks for 592 ml. And if you're someone like me who has to wash hair quite often and go swimming every day, you can't really invest in like expensive stuff. I mean, if you can, well, good for you, but I can't. So for anyone out there, this is a really good shampoo. The second wash, I use this Tresemme Beautiful Volume Step 2 shampoo. This shampoo is really good because it gives the right amount of moisture and the right amount of cleaning. So I really like this one. So now that I'm done with shampooing, then I will go with the conditioner. The conditioner that I use is the Garnier Fructus Long and Strong Strengthening Conditioner. This conditioner is the best conditioner that I have used on my hair. When it comes to, you know, swimming and hair repair kind of a thing, I have tried numerous conditioners from Tresemme, from L'Oreal, you name it, whatever the commercial stores have these days, but nothing hydrates and keeps the hair healthy like this one. So I highly recommend this. The second thing that I would, so this is what I use on a regular basis, because I come back home at about 9 o'clock in the night, so I really don't have a lot of time to do a lot. This is my basic night routine for my hair after swimming. Weekly once, I do two more, I use two more products which I would highly recommend. One of them is this Meera Herbal Hair Wash Powder. There is a shampoo version of this available. I do not recommend that. The powder is really strong. It will strip your hair out of any chemical that you have. So I highly recommend this one once a week only, because it's really strong. It tends to dry out your hair a lot. Take a little bit of powder, put some water in it, massage your hair nicely, get into your scalp and massage it, and then leave it on for 3 minutes and then wash it off. Trust me, your hair will be squeaky clean. Another product that I use is this Ketaconazole Scalp Solution 2%. I don't want to give out too much detail about this, because this was recommended to me by my dermatologist, because I have really oily skin and itchy scalp at times. So itchy scalp is a common thing you're going to face if you're swimming regularly. This really helps with that. It's not an anti-dandruff, or it's not a fancy solution to anything. It's just to calm your scalp down because of all the chemicals that is going into your scalp. It's just a calming solution. That is it. That was regarding my hair care, the daily and the weekly routine that I do. Coming to my face, I try to keep it very simple, because it's better to use less products but effective products than a lot of them that do may or may not be doing, or maybe they're clashing each other. So I don't like to use moisturizer, toner, cleanser, all of these things. I don't do that. When the winter comes, I use Cetaphil, which is a very common cleanser. I don't have it now. I will put a picture, but it's quite a common product that many people use. In summer, because my skin is very, very oily, I just use a normal soap. I use Mysore Sandal Soap or Pears. These two are my go-to soaps. So once that is done, I use a moisturizer. I use this moisturizer. It's called Trioblok. it was recommended to me by my dermatologist. I am not sure how safe it is for people to use it. I would really recommend that you go speak to your dermatologist about this. If not this, there will be similar products for your skin tone. So the thing is, these are very basic creams. They don't have a lot of fancy fragrance and, you know, other kind of things. They basically just moisturize and lighten your skin. Because I have patchy skin and the uneven skin tone, and because of swimming and all of that, this was recommended to me. So I would suggest that you meet with a dermatologist and at least understand the kind of skin that you have. Based on that, you can buy the cream. The dermatologist will recommend it to you. The thing is, these creams have some amount of acid in it, which basically helps in like mild exfoliation, and over a period of time your skin tan and uneven skin tone sort of fades out. That's how it works. So different creams have different acid, and different skin types work with different kinds of acid. So my skin, for example, will immediately get pimples if it comes in contact with anything that has salicylic acid. Now, if you want to know an example, Clean and Clear has salicylic acid in their face washes, so I cannot use that. So this is just an example. I'm sure, your skin might be allergic or sensitive to certain kinds of acids in the cream. So I would suggest you meet with a dermatologist, get these things clarified, and based on their suggestion, you can go for whichever cream they suggest. There are many creams like this out there which are not available in the normal commercial shops. These are available only at the pharmacies. So these are actually very good though. It's sad that they don't get the kind of advertisements that Fair and Lovely or Pond's or L'Oreal gets, but these are really good. Another cream that I use is this Deso Night Gel. This is the one. This is for dry skin, really dry skin. I get dry skin here and like some patches on my cheek, nose and this T-zone. And I don't use this one when I'm going out. This is just at night once I'm done swimming to make sure my skin is well hydrated. Otherwise, it's usually Trioblok, because this has a sunscreen and it helps in whitening as well. So this is for my face. So this was it, guys. I know there are a lot of products that I've mentioned. You might be confused, you might have questions. You can definitely leave them at the comments down below. I'll try to answer them. I'll try to clarify, because I myself have tried so many and rejected so many. Some are still like working, but all of the products that I have mentioned here are something that I've been using for the last 3 months, and they have given me results and I'm able to manage my skin better. Trust me, this was not the situation when I first started swimming. My face was really, really dark. I have managed to somehow make it less tanned and less patchy. So if you have any doubts, please let me know. Many of the products that I've mentioned here are not from like the conventional shops. They are dermatologist recommended. Please do not buy them and try them on your own. You might end up with some kind of an issue, and I don't want to take responsibility for those kind of things. Do your own research. These are just things that work for me. You can definitely take these names and check with your local dermatologist or skin doctor and use them as well. So guys, I will see you in my next video. Until then, please take care, like, share and subscribe. Bye bye.